Hello everybody, I'm Undead and welcome back to Ender the Gungeon. Since the last time I uploaded a video of Gungeon, many things happened both in the game and outside the game, but let's not talk about the things outside the game because they kinda changed how I treat YouTube and let's not talk about that. In the game, I unlocked the bullet and killed the past and also discovered that I like rainbow mode very much. So let's play a bullet rainbow run. So what is rainbow mode? You don't get to open chest during the run and you don't get to buy items from the shop, and generally anything that is an item and that would drop is not allowed. You only get one chest at the beginning of each floor, and that includes a bunch of random items, and you only get to choose one. An exception to that appears to be spice for whatever reason, so let's see how this goes. Let's open the chest. Can't say I like those things. The turret, some guns, this is not useful. The coolness thing, the cigarettes might be useful, but I'm not sure. The sling though, it's not useful either, so let's get void core cannon. So what is the thing with the bullet? You start with blasphemy, which is a sword that can block bullets, and when you're at full health it throws these sword projectiles. So it's quite a fun character to play, so let's get going. And first room there, let's block some bullets just so you can see, and let's see if I can do this nicely. Also, it gets a bit harder if you're not in full health, because as I said, if you're not in full health, you don't shoot the sword projectiles. So let's try and keep our health maybe. And I died to a grenade. Let's start this over. Okay, restarted. Let's try and stay focused this time. What do we have? We got the sling, the sniper rifle. Ooh, and this is a liquid Valkyrie, I think. Yes, it slows down their projectiles, so I think it's good. You just have to be careful with explosive enemies. They get near you, and in order to hit them, if you don't have full health, it gets a bit trickier. And there, see, if you have rainbow tone, you don't get drops as items or chests in the rooms. So let's get moving. Ooh, and I want... What the fuck is going on? What the freak is going on? What are these enemies? It's a bit early for them, don't you think? There. Oh, barely dodged these. And couple of books. Down they go. Next room. Nothing that interesting happened except the fact that we got a golden chest. Screw you, game. Remember, even though you can't get the items, you can trust them for maybe perhaps junk, a piece of health. That's okay. Let's go back now. Found the boss room. Let's clear the floor first. Or rather, let's not. Let's fight the boss right away. It's our best chance of surviving. The trigger twins. I think I can deal with you. And now he's pissed. Let's try and not get hurt. There we go. Perfect boss battle with the trigger twins. That was nice. And we get a piece of armor and the health upgrade. We needed that. So let's full clear the floor and go bleed. Oh, there is the fireplace room. Roll the barrel. Boom, boom, and hit it. Now, should I buy an extra key from the shop? Maybe, if I find it. There's the shop. Ooh, also you can buy the map. Apparently, I didn't know that. Let's buy a key now that they're cheap, and maybe a piece of armor. Let's clear the floor first and then buy another piece of armor, because we need to keep our full health, the red health, just in order to shoot the swords. Oh, found the other item room. Let's trash it. just another piece of health. All right, let's check for secret rooms. Not here, maybe near the final exit. No. All right, let's go to the shop. Buy a piece of armor and get the hell out of here. Now, I'm going Oubliette, but I'm not sure I'll go Abbey of the True Gun. It would be good to go because more items, but I don't like that place. Oubliette, let's open the chest. And Potion of Gun Friendship and the Bell. Those are both interesting items. One will increase our damage, the other will make it so time stops for a little while. Let's get the bell. Let's get the bell and move forward. And four snipers here. They're gonna go down easy. Oh, one is a master sniper or something. Let's get you from afar if I can. Yeah, apparently I could. Oh, and mushroom guy. Yeah, I will definitely kill you from afar. There, there. Next room. Oh, these brown slimes. I hate them. Orange, brown, whatever they are. Because they kinda bend bullets around and... And watch out for... Yeah, the freaking flying bullets. It's alright, that's why I bought an extra piece of armor, so... Alright, found the shop, but... Nothing else of interest happens, so yeah. And the Gunmancer that we will not use. Found the crest room. We will take the crest, even though I don't plan on going Abbey of the True Gun. So yeah, there's that. I like killing slimes with the blasphemy because it separates them in just one hit, and it's amazing. If you're not careful, slimes will get you. Ooh, and... the first item room, let's trash the chest. Just a note, it would drop a normal item, so it didn't. Okay. Oh, and we have big holsters in the Oubliette. Oh yes, we usually do have them, so I shouldn't be that surprised. There, there, all done. Oh, and the trap room. Oh, it's one of the easier ones, so... I got hit. Yeah. I shouldn't speak. Give me a piece of armor. No? Okay. Oh, how many grenades have you spawned? At least that took care of the ghost as well. And another trap room. Is this... It's... quite simple, you just gotta be fast. Second item room, let's trash it. Yeah, it's just junk. Unfortunately, I don't think we'll be getting junkan by trashing chests anymore. Mainly because I think I unlocked junkan as a normal item, a normal chest item. But I think there is still a small chance to get him when trashing the chest. Ooh, mushrooms. Oh, this thing. Is there a giant face over there? Yeah, those can be dangerous. Oh, it wasn't. All right. Just the flying dude. And we made the boss room. We explored the whole floor. Was there a piece of armor here? No, just key, ammo, and red health. All right, let's fight the Blobby Lord. And keep hitting with everything you got. When things get hard, use the bell. But keep hitting from afar, because getting close to him, not a good idea. Yeah, let's use the freaking bell. I could block that last attack with my sword, but yeah, I prefer dodging it, so what can you do? And now you will explode, I think. Yes. And get ready to attack again. Oh, you're exploding again. Come on. You just exploded, dude. That can't be good for your health. I had to use a blank there, but it's okay. We had one extra. And I think you're down, so boom you go. Sometimes the bosses are easier than the actual enemies in the game, so that's that. Let's look for the secret room. It's not here. Where could it be? It could be in this item room or that item room. Yeah, that looks more promising. Also, let's get the crest. No, it's not here. Okay, I guess. Second floor, Gungeon proper. What do we have here? Oh. Hungry bullets is really interesting, so let's go with that. It makes it so our projectiles can block actual bullets from the enemies. Sometimes, not always, unfortunately. Maybe it's only for guns and not for the blasphemy weapon. Ooh, that was close. There. Maybe it was a bad choice, taking the hungry bullets. But, I'm all for bad choices, so... Found an item room. We don't get the item, we get the junk. Or a piece of health. Also good. Oh, and there's a buff magician here. Let's get him first. And a cube down here. All done. Ooh, that was an overly populated room. Found the boss room. Should I go right away? Maybe I should, but first let's visit the shop. Just in case I get to drop my crest. And can we buy the node key? No, I don't have the money, so we're not going Chrysalis full rat yet. Also, I haven't yet defeated the Chrysalis full rat because... Well, there goes my crest. Yeah, I was saying I haven't defeated the Chrysalis full rat because I got there one time, but then got confused in the maze and completed. Ooh, I hadn't completed that. So let's try and keep ourselves at full health because we're gonna need it for the boss. Oh, and an extra key, let's grab that. Even though it's not that useful. I got hit by a freaking grenade there. I just need one piece of health. Let's not break this chest because it might explode. There was the crest room. Of course, it would be the last room we visited. Yeah, that's games for you. All right, let's go, boss. Please, let it not be the door lord. Oh, beholster. Well, it's okay, I guess. And boom, and activate. Hit him as hard as you can while he's frozen. And get the hell away from him. What I hate about the Beholster, it's not his attacks per se as much. It's the little freaking dudes he spawns. There, this one. This is what gets me every time with the freaking Beholster. See, it happened again. He drops him right in front of my fucking face. I hate you. You messed up my run. Doesn't matter, I guess. We will do what we have to do. The mines, let's see what we have. Ooh. Now, this is enticing, the metronome, because it will... raise our stats every time we get a kill and we don't get hurt. The chicken flute is also interesting. This chamber, I'm not sure what it does. Yeah, let's get the metronome. And let's once again try and not get hurt. Oh, and right here we have not Link trying to map the floor, so yeah, let's help him. He usually gives a reward. Yeah, yeah, we will complete the map for you, dude. Oh, found the first item room. Let's trash it again. A piece of health. Always useful. And I think our metronome is getting at full strength? Maybe. Oh, now we have the displacer beasts, or whatever the game wants to call them. There we go. And giant mushrooms? No, just mind flayers. That's okay, though. Found the soap. Let's see what kind of items you have. Oh, you don't have any pieces of armor. Yeah. Found the boss room. Yeah, I'll go boss first before I finish the map. Cannon Balrog. Ooh, I haven't fought Cannon Balrog with the bullet yet. This will be interesting. I'm getting way too close at him. Let him roll around. I can't see where I'm... Oh, he goes dark. That's okay, that's okay. We can make this work. And he's back. Let him shoot once. Let him roll around. Return to normal, and then we use the bell. And let's hit you as fast as we can, and away we go. Yes, yes, only the freaking beholster. Only that. I hate the beholster. We must do something about that. But that's just me being salty, I guess. So, what can you do? Oh, now I think it's at full strength, our metronome. Because I'm killing enemies at one hit. Ooh, this is nice, actually. Yeah, metronome was a good thing to take. Unless you get hurt and it resets to zero. Then you have to do it all over again. And let's not trash it yet, because they have the tendency to explode. How many rooms left? Just a couple. Oh, vampire lady that we can buy nothing from. Oh, and we completed the map. Yeah, that's nice. Now we can return to not Link. Where is the other one? Oh, it's a spider. Let's see what will happen to you. That was nice. So, not Link. Yes, yes, here is the completed map. Oh, and we got nothing. Just the satisfaction that we completed his quest. Do I have enough health in here? Yes, thank God. Fourth floor, let's refill our metronome and go. Those are some interesting things. The sixth chamber makes it so our coolness raises as our curse raises, which means the more curse we have, the more coolness we have. And coolness means that there is a better chance for items to drop when clearing a room, be that health, keys, armor, or chests, or items. Now, the frozen heart is also good because it's a health up. And when you get damage, we sort out freezing bullets. Little Sally, also good, because he can take care of some enemies, but I think I have to go for the armor. I think I do. A less insane than me person would take Little Sally, but I'm gonna go with armor, yes. Oh, and we have a summoner in here. That's not good. That's not good. Yeah, down you go. Ooh, I have zero will to fight the big skeletons, so I want to take care of them before they appear. Oh, that was close. Oh, and we have you. Is that all? Yeah, now we're done. It's not worth it doing the challenge, because the chest we get will have that dude sitting on top of it, and we can't get anything, so let's not waste our money. Not that we will use them somehow, except if the Forge Lady has some health or some other things we could buy. Now, the only reason I should full clear this floor is, maximizing my metronome, but I'm not sure I'm in the mood for that. It's dangerous, to say the least, because I might get hurt and it will be all for nothing. Let's find the boss room first and see what we do afterwards. That was nice. Yeah, the little zombie dudes. Those are nice for filling up the metronome. Also, the bullet takes no contact damage and deals a lot more contact damage with dodge roll. Are we at full strength again? I sure hope so. Another piece of armor, that's always great. Oh, the cell creep, I have nothing to give you. Found the boss room. A couple of rooms left down there. Screw it, let's do it. Is it the wall? Yes. The wall is manageable because we can block lots of his bullets. And that's nice. Please, next floor, give me a Yari Lancer. I would seriously love to have that weapon now. Especially for the dragon, it's amazing. And that's how you fight the wall with the bullet. Mainly by blocking all his shots. Another health up, I missed only the one from the freaking beholster and now I'm cringy. Anyway, let's move on to the next floor and first let's try and find the secret rooms. Didn't find them, doesn't matter, let's move. We made it to the forge, come on chest, give me Yari Lancer or something I could carry to the bullets past. No, we got a bunch of... well, let's say not that useful for us items. Let's get the Gungeon Stone. I think that now our metronome is at full power because it does a higher pitched clink noise when I kill somebody. And also it turned red, so red usually means full power, I'm guessing. Oh, and the hammer room. That's not very nice, this specific layout, but we made it. I still can't one-shot the fucking ghosts. So I'm guessing. Yeah, metronome. Ease of help, but come on, please let me... almost fell there. This is the one that we have to use blanks in order for a chance to get some chest. Yeah, no, I'm not gonna do that because I can't use the chest. And I'm on fire. Oh, okay. Dodge that. Trust this one. Junkan? No. I think it might be time for our bell to be used. I don't want to... oh, fuck up my metronome. Oof. Where's the summoner? Where's the summoner? Oof, 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 oof. That almost turned out to be really bad for us. Watch out for the fires here. That's what's gonna get me. And there's one more. And nothing new spawned in. Let's wait out the fires. And boom. And off you go. And off I go. Oh, there's a Grim Reaper here. Oh, like that. I don't know why I was so worried about this. Okay, something happened there, but can't exactly tell what. This jammed cell just doesn't want to die. Another piece of armor, yeah. Alright, that was an exploding chest. Let's go up there. Also, we have one room down there. I should find the Forge Lady because I want to get the bullet that can kill the past and, well, kill the past. oh, these guys that take your projectiles, yeah, they can take the sword projectiles too, so be careful around them. I fell down. No, my metronome. No. I'm sad now. Found the boss room, but I messed it up by falling down the pit. Yeah, just my luck. Where the freak is that forge lady? I guess I should call her a blacksmith, but has she been presented as a blacksmith? There she is. All right, you have ammo, a key, and a piece of armor. I'll take that. I'm super bummed that my metronome is... Yeah, I destroyed that. But what can you do? Let's go face the dragon. Now, this is an interesting battle with the bullet. Just have to stay focused not to get hurt by anything he shoots, and the sword will deal good damage to him. Don't throw the knives, don't throw the knives. This is okay, just don't throw the knives. I got hurt. Okay, I was a bit reckless there. Doesn't matter, we're just going to the past. And everything changes there. Use a blank, because why not? I'm trying to get near him in order to get more damage, both by the projectile and the swing of the sword. But I'm not doing that much damage to him. You brought out the sword, the knives. Well, screw you too, yes? Well, he's nearing phase two, so maybe I shouldn't care about the knives. You got me? Seriously? Well, that was obvious. Let's use this. Yeah. Yeah, I'm using the bell. And I'll have to use another blank right away. Screw you, dude. This is the worst fight I ever had with a dragon. The knives again. The fucking knives. Yeah, fantastic. Fantastic. There was no way I couldn't get hurt there. Can I do this? Can I actually fucking do this? Maybe I can't. I'm getting hit all around and he just doesn't want to go to phase two. I'm tanking it. Screw it. Just switch phases already. Using the bell again. Why won't you switch faces? Phases, rather. Not faces. Don't switch faces. Well, I guess you actually do switch your face a bit as well. For flip's sake. That was terrible. That was seriously terrible on my part. But as I said, it's okay. We have to survive this and just get to the past. And yeah, destroy the heart. I'm gonna have to do this 5 times maybe. Oh boy, speeding up. Finally. Was it 5 or 6 times? Oh boy, let's go kill the past and be over with it. Gungeon proper, the past. Some years prior. Who are you? Oh, my younglet, only you can save us. I tried to yield our ancestral weapon, but the design is alien to me. When I aim at fire, it just stabs me in the head. Even though it has lost much of its great power, it's said that it can reflect the magic of that dark wizard. I fear all is lost. But perhaps you can succeed where I have missed. Aim through my... Are you dead? Yes, you are. And this is the original blasphemy. It doesn't shoot projectiles, it only blocks... I can't remember if it blocks bullets either. And yeah, it's a hell of a fight to have. First we face these two gun knights here. It doesn't block bullets. Yeah, I remember correctly. This is going to be fun. It does quite a bit of damage though. Already got hurt. Just because I want to do this quickly, I got hurt. And there you go. And now we go behind the thrones and face the very obvious reference to Zelda. The bullet person. The spell is almost complete. Soon my quick draw master rises. All Bulegid will be slave to his grandeur, to be fired by his will. I have learned from your undead master, but I'm not his kind. The usurper shall soon reign. Turn back now, return to your path to the chamber and rejoin the rest of your pathetic kind. Or do you think you can stop me? Go ahead on. Alright, so this dude shoots many things, but every now and then he will shoot a purple thingy that we can reflect back to him. Is it now? I think so. No, no, it's not. So mainly it's a, you know, a test of not might, but waiting it out. I think this one will be that. And boom, you go. First time, you need to hit it just once. Second time, I think you need to hit it 3 times. And third time, you need to hit it like 5 or 4. And now you throw this one. Go on, give me the one that can hurt you. This is it? Yes. And once, and twice, and 3 times we'll do it. Once more. Oh, does that. This is not it, I think. Oh, it is. But be careful, he can kinda throw it in, not in your direction. There we go. No! Must. And now we face the true boss of the bullet's past, which is blatantly Ganon. But it's alright, it's nice. Ganon, but with guns. And his name is Canon. I like it. Now, we must get real close to hurt him, but he does a bunch of ugly stuff that we must avoid. So let's be careful. This is gonna be a slow ride. I'm gonna speed it up. And yeah. Oh, almost got hurt there, I think, maybe. Also, you have to watch out for, yeah, the pits. And these bullets will turn into bats. His attacks are precisely those of Ganon in The Link to the Past. So, yeah, if you know that battle, you will be okay. You have 2 blanks and 3 hits to get, but I'm down to... No, not 3, 6. I'm down to... 5 already. And he attacks non-stop, of course. I'm on just one more hit, down you go. Alright, that was easier than the dragon actually. It's not a hard battle. And of course, the Link pose. And in your head it goes. And it gains its true power and becomes the blasphemy. It's not the hardest fight, but yeah, it's forced to be slow, so yeah, that makes it a bit. And here all the Gungeon Dungeons are having fun. And that was it for the bullets fast. Alright, it was a weird run. I wasn't being very careful, so I got damage sometimes that I shouldn't have got. And yeah, other than that, I delivered what I promised, so that was nice. I will see you all in the next one. Until then, stay safe and have fun.